Fucking
And we are actually meeting up for a Sunday lunch in a pub in Powick. I'm a Powick and I don't know it. It's all outside and obviously I just hope it doesn't rain again. Because last time we were out eating soup in the rain, it took us an hour and a half to finish it.
And I know what, I had to go to the doctor's last week because I'm completely addicted to Polo's mints. And the doctor told me I've got a menthol health problem.
I want to take you home and eat you. Wow. What am I? A Titan away?
Got your mate on it as well.
Boris, he came to Wolverhampton last week.
Did he?
Yeah, yeah. I was saying, we talk about houses. I bought my house for £150,000, right? After Boris came, it's worth 50. Yeah.
However, I also have flat feet, which earned me the nickname at school of Caveman!
Like, I've always hated those Asian comics who talk about they have small dicks, you know. It's like, what are you doing? Things are already hard enough for us.
Everybody, welcome back to Henn Nights Live number, I've stopped counting. I really have stopped counting. But we're here. We've got seven shows left. Seven shows. That means in 7 weeks, everything will be over and we'll all be going out doing comedy next to people coughing all over us. It'll be great. It will be great. Please do me a favour. If you are watching this now, I know last week we had a record number of viewers last week. I want to see if we can get a few more viewers. So if you are watching this now, if you're watching on Facebook, share it on Facebook. If you're watching it on YouTube, share it on YouTube. Do you know what I'm saying? Share it. Also, if you could do me a big favour, and you can watch this on your big smart TVs on YouTube, which is great. It is. We've got some great acts tonight as well. I'll tell you all about them when I remember their names. I'm just waiting for you to share it, really. You know, last time I told you that me and the wife, we went for a conciliatory meeting up last week. We went to, we had a weekend. It was last weekend in Powick, right? That's at the foot of the Malvern Hills. I actually proposed to my wife on top of the Malvern Hills, although she said it was too cold, so we did it in the back seat of the car. That was even before they gave it a name, you know. Do you know, dogging, for that is what it was, it's not in itself a crime, but it can be if an outside party, someone who sees you doing it, are themselves offended by it. So I suppose that means that people watching it and cracking one off, as long as they're not offended by the performance, then in itself is not the crime. The crime, obviously, is not giving your all, as it were. I suppose it's what you do with it rather than just doing it. And when I say it, you cancel culturists, I mean the act itself, rather than one's bird. Always finish on the Eiffel Tower. as Eric Cantona would say. So yeah, it was going to be a special meal outside within the shadows of the Malvern Hills. What could possibly go wrong? Look, I know we haven't been out for ages. Well, the ones who actually think it makes a difference haven't. And they haven't yet, which surprises me, Rushy Wanker, actually used the phrase eat out side to help out. But you get the drift. It's just nice to have someone to wait on you and ask you if you're having a nice day. When we got there, there was a rather nice voiced server, showed us to our table. I say table, I mean picnic bench on the sloping grass next to the car park and the line of concrete bollards between us and the A449. Thank you, I said. My wife said sarcastically, this is very na 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 nice. The server gave us a rather grubby piece of paper that said, this is your very own single-use, responsibly sourced, disposable menu. I fear the smudged, gravy-stained thumbprint in the top right corner suggested it wasn't. And my wife, she was convinced it was reusable toilet paper. The server said, my name is... And then I asked if that was spelt with two R's. They laughed at me, and I'm sure it would have lit up their face, but they were wearing a mask. And then I said something that I wanted to say for ages. And I know it's wrong and it's 2021 and not 1971, but I said it anyway. I looked at them and I said, I'd love to rip your mask off. Gary smiled and said, I'd love to rip you and you shh, as the articulated lorry let off its air brakes. Although it was nice to go out, it was, but it was one of those meals where you buy one, you get one free. You buy one, you get one free. But when the one meal is £20, I don't think it's much of a saving. Also, they gave me a glass. I only had a lime and soda, but it was smudgy all on the outside. So it was, yeah. But it was nice to get out. It's just nice to get out these days. Gary came back. I said to Gary, I said, what do you recommend? And Gary said, oh, I recommend the bark, 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 mushroom soup. I said, why'd you make a noise like a chicken? He said, I can't make a noise like a mushroom. And he went off laughing. So we sat down between the slats of wood, and as I looked at the passengers of the 144 on the way to Worcester, I said to the wife, well, at least we're out. Hey, Wade's with us tonight, everyone. Tonight? I don't even know what tonight. I've got tonices and tonephews. Yeah, Wade's with us tonight, which would be nice. Wade has tried to several times to do his set for you, but the internet connections keeps... What am I doing? My goodness, where would I be without an overlay? So many overlays, so little time. Hey, thank you. Please, I'm not sure if you are sharing this, but you've got some great people coming up tonight. We have Wade, we've got Kelly Edgar, we've got Av Singh, we've got Joel RX. As in she's prescribed. Prescription. And then finishing off Tony Cowards. You never thought I'd say that tonight, did you? Right. Shall we get our first... Oh, no. Let's go and see Av, because Av might not be on top form tonight. Av had his second jab yesterday, and it was Pfizer. So apparently second jab Pfizer makes you a little bit icky wicky poorly. Icky wicky poorly. So let's say hello to icky wicky poorly Av. Hi Av.
You alright, Steve?
Are you icky wicky poorly?
Yeah. Well, I'm struggling to get any words out. No, yeah.
Really?
Yeah, yeah.
No. It's not difficult though, is it?
Go on.
I forgot what I was going to say. I was going to say, when did you have your jab? Yesterday afternoon or in the morning?
In the morning. I did in the morning. And it was a slow deterioration throughout the day.
Yeah. But that's, I mean, because I had the the Oxford, the what's it, the AstraZeneca.
So Oxford.
Oxford, yeah. My jab's better than yours because I don't get side effects apparently after my second.
I was talking about this earlier. I thought, you know, maybe there might be some like vaccine snobbery coming along, you know? Because you're saying that AstraZeneca, that, and people say, you know, what do you have here, AstraZeneca? Well, that's old, that is. That's old. There's issues with that. They say, well, I've had the Pfizer, you know? Oh, I've had the Moderna. And you may say, oh, I've had Johnson & Johnson. And you say, well, you had Boris and his dad, you dirty cow, Jennifer.
You dirty cow, Jennifer.
Jennifer Curry, the other one had a affair with Boris.
I see. I've not watched the news for the last 2 days. I have no idea. Somebody could have died earlier and I wouldn't have known. No, I might be talking ill of somebody and I wouldn't know it. I know that the country's still right.
Has Redditch gone blue, Steve?
Have you seen our MP?
No.
Oh, we used to have the Home Secretary as our MP, and she got caught for watching porn on a TV and charging it for expenses. So we've been blue for a while.
Oh dear. Oh.
Anyway, I only just wanted to check in to see how you were actually, Av, but I'll come back later. I just hoping it still, you know, you were still funny and everything.
I've never been funny. Yeah, and you know that as well.
True. I was going to say goodbye. I'll come back to you in a bit. Did you want to say something?
No.
Bye. Hey, so that's Av. Av will be back. He's not. I was really worried. I thought he'd be poorly, but he's right. So now, lay back, enjoy. I've got no interview with this man because this man has phoned in his performance. I know, but I'll tell you what. If you're not a big fan of Wade before the show, then you should be a big fan of Wade now. This is his show. Ladies and gentlemen, Wade!
Well, Mr. Steve, as we spoke last week, I was having some technical...
difficulties.
Mm-hmm. I love your hat, by the way. Has anyone told you you got a slick hat? I mean, that is tough. Okay, I'm gonna go, Steve. The walls are not responding. The walls here I'm talking to are not even roasting me back, so all right. God bless you, and stay cool, Steve. Take care of yourself. Word to your mother. Peace out.
And that's the trailer, to be honest with you. But that's all right. I made a mistake. But that's one of the world's greatest things. And also, my other computer has now gone off, but it's good. But it puts me in time. I'm not over. Oh, I've got to speak for another 5 minutes. That's going to be difficult because that was going to be 5 minutes of Wade. I'll tell you what. We'll let the comedians have an extra minute each. How about that instead of me doing it? Look at them saying, oh, thank you so much. That's very generous of you. And someone's saying, no, not having that. Kelly, I can see Kelly shaking her head. Let's see what Kelly thinks of anything, really. I was going to say, let's go see what Kelly thinks of Wade, but that's probably not right. Kelly! Hello!
I love Wade.
How are you?
I'm good.
Yes. I uploaded the wrong bit of video. That was his promotional video. I'll see if I can find it and play him at the end.
It's very good. Yeah.
Oh, thank you.
Give him his minutes. Give him his minutes, please.
Yeah. Don't you want an extra minute? Go on. Have an extra minute.
I don't know. There's a barrel here. Let me scrape the bottom of it and see what I can fish out for you.
Oh, bless you. No, I haven't seen you for ages. Where have you been?
Where have I been?
At home.
Yeah, here. Haven't moved.
Anything exciting happened in the last 12 months?
No.
No. Have you been Have you been outside to eat out?
No. Oh, I'll tell you what, I got a light bulb from here. That was quite fun. Because I didn't have one. Oh, yeah, all right.
I travel with my own light bulb. It's cool.
So you brought, very good,
did you go to the shop or did you just Amazon it?
I got it Amazoned.
Yeah. Everyone's saying, oh, Amazon's destroying the high street. But, you know, it'll be with you to 6 to 8 hours. I'm happy.
I'm all right. Terrible. I even got a Yushanka from Amazon. I get my communist regalia from Amazon.
Did you call me a shanker?
Ushanka. It's a hat.
Is it?
Yeah.
Is it there? Can you show me what an Ushanka is? I don't even know what an Ushanka is.
Yeah, hang on a minute.
Ladies, I'll tell you what, I'll go. I'm rubbish at this. She's gone to get her her thing. That's excellent. Here she is with her. Oh, is that your Ushanka?
Yeah, I can't get it on over the headphones, but yeah.
I've got one. You talk.
Oh God, no! What?
I didn't realise it was an Ushanka.
Yeah.
Oh. Do I go like that? Oh.
Yeah. Yeah.
That's really quite. That's real rabbit. Here.
Now you see that's too much.
Is it too much? I was trying to get a deer skin one, but it was too deer, so it's molting. That is, I'm going right. Are you ready?
I'll have to be, won't I?
Yeah. I'm pressing the wrong buttons. We could go to somebody else. So let's hope we've got. Ladies and gentlemen, back in the hen house, it's the wonderful Kelly Edgar.
Hello. Hi, everybody. Thanks for having me. I am not drunk. You'll be glad to know. Yeah. But, as I was just saying there, I still haven't been out. Everywhere's opening up and I've got nowhere to go. I have recently moved back up to the northeast, and I don't really know anyone here, and it's a bit boring because I was separated from my husband, and that was good. It was shit actually, but it was just one of them things, you know, like it was a bit like that Pulp song, Our Relationship, but he was from Cyprus and he had a thirst for crack, so didn't really work out. But you know, I got the dog and he got arrested, so yeah, it's all good. It's really difficult to save up as well. I'm trying to, like, work's sparse and I've got to save up £500 for divorce proceedings, but I did it. I worked all the way through lockdown, saved really hard. I saved up £500 and finally I can say that I have got this sweet tattoo of a gorilla, so go me. But it's just hard not to feel like a bit of a loser. I mean, I know I don't look it, but I'm 41 and I'm just sort of feeling really shit. I mean, don't look it in the face, but you should see my vagina. Oh, dear. But, you know, just a lot of people have achieved so much by my age, and I don't feel like I've achieved a thing. Like Dennis Nielsen, right? Dennis Nielsen. Serial killer, by the time he was arrested at 37, he'd already killed 15 people, right? 37, 15, I'm 41, and I've only killed one person. And I mean, technically, it was an abortion, but just let me have the win. Let me have the win. And I will say, sometimes people don't react very well to that joke, but if you find serial killers okay and women's bodily autonomy not okay, I would invite you to look inside. But I've been thinking about how I can, succeed, what I could do, what I really want to do. Right? I really want to be on like a TV quiz show. I think it'd be great because it actually runs in the family. My dad, right, was on Bullseye, got 8 out of 9, Bully Special Prize, didn't go to the final because he'd had a lovely day. And he came home with, a knitting machine, but he's great. And also my cousin, is a gladiator, one of the original gladiators, which is really cool, but nobody cares because it's not Jet. So, sorry. But the quiz show that I'd really want to be on is called Only Connect. I don't know if you've seen it. It's quite highbrow. I don't know if you've noticed. I'm not. So I'm a bit worried about how it would go, because I mean, basically the setup is when they introduce the teams, they introduce each person individually, tell you what they do, what they've qualified in, and then some like really sort of benign fact about themselves. Tenuous link to a celebrity is always good. It's a little bit like this. So welcome to Only Connect. Today on my left, we are joined by Matthew, a marketing executive who once refused to sell a SIM card to Sarah Ferguson. We've got Andy, a natural sciences graduate who can recite pi to 300 digits. And their team captain, Finella, an accountant who once beat Giles Brandreth's cousin's daughter at Guess Who. United by their love of Dungeons & Dragons, they are the virgins. But like me and my friends, I don't think it would go down as well, because it'd have to be like, and on my left, we've got Kelly, a physics graduate who once did ketamine with former members of S Club 7 and then was sick into her own cupped hands. And we've got Louise, an aspiring actress whose only film credit to date is an extra in a vampire porno where she ate a bag of crisps. And their team captain is Sarah, a grown woman who thinks that foxes are a type of cat. And united by their complete and total lack of self-respect, they're not going to win. So, I don't know. It might work, might not. But, Zoom's good, isn't it? Like, it's nice to have Zoom. I hope it doesn't go, because it's been a lifesaver for me. Gigs like this are amazing. I hope they continue. Some things on Zoom are great, some things aren't. I did a comedy course with Louis C.K. and it was called Pull Back and Reveal. Wouldn't recommend it. My local pub are doing a rhetorical quiz night. Why? I think I'm just lonely, you know, like I haven't got any kids. Not that I know of, anyway. Right, girls. But I have got my dog. I promised I wouldn't talk about my dog, but I'm going to talk about my dog because he's great and I love my dog. Guess what sort of dog I've got? Yeah, it's a pug. Obviously, look at the state of me. It's a pug. If you're not familiar with them, just imagine like a potato with a face on. If Pokemon's your thing, the evolution would go pug, French bulldog, potato. That's the kind of level we're talking about. But I didn't know all the problems that come with them. Like, I was really naive going into it, and I didn't know that all of the horrible, horrible medical problems that they can have because of the way they're bred. And I was like, oh, look, its head's the same size as its body. What could possibly go wrong? Turns out quite a lot. So I do feel bad, but he is my only friend, and he's been great during lockdown. And he's also refusing to sit on my knee. So this is him for the purposes of this. But, you know, we talk, we have good chats. It's nice. You know, I'll say like, hi, buddy, how you doing? And he'll say to me, and I'm a dog, I've got no concept of time. And I'll say, do you want to go for a walk? And he'll say, well, okay, but not too far, because I've got these like really stenotic nares and an overly long soft palate, and it makes breathing like a struggle. So then I'll say, yeah, sorry about that. Yeah, sorry. And he'll say, did you know that my mother was so aggressively overbred that her vagina's on the outside? And I'll be like, shit, sorry, man. And I just have to give him a cuddle, but like not too hard or his eyes will pop out, you know. Do you know what? That I've gone on long enough. Did I do an extra minute? Is that long enough? Stop me talking.
That was really good. That sounds. I hate saying that because it sounds really patronising. It's like, I don't expect it. Do you know what I mean? Oh, well, I did expect it to be good. But no, it's I wanted to pick you up on a couple of things. I say pick you up.
Right. Go on, then.
Louis C.K. joke.
Yeah. Sorry, brilliant. Yeah.
No, brilliant. Brilliant. Yeah. No, yeah, no, but brilliant, brilliant. I laughed very much at that, and I went to see him live, and I feel it's difficult, isn't it? When you like what somebody, is? And then you go, ooh, but,
absolutely gutted. I really thought he was one of the good ones, but
I know. Mm. But I still got my box set of Jim Will Fix It, so I don't care. But I said that out loud, didn't I? That's the danger. No, I love the way you say you haven't got any children, not that you know of. Because I used to say that when I was younger, thinking I was big and clever. Do you know what I mean? And it just makes me, I'm glad you do that. So
yeah. If I was a kangaroo, it'd be like plausible, but I'm not.
Well, that's true. You could change your name to Joey, I suppose, Joey Edgar. Yeah. Do you know something about kangaroos?
I learned some kangaroo facts the other day.
About the that's baby. What? It crawls up into the pouch. Yeah. Doesn't. Yeah.
Yeah.
Let me into the warmth, Mum. Yeah. I don't think they speak like that. You know what I mean?
But imagine, what if you lost it?
Like, oh. What?
Like, it'd just be like, oh well, you know.
It's good. You know, because you before lockdown, you'd only done a few live gigs, hadn't you?
Like three, four?
Three.
Yeah.
You see?
Yeah, still.
So
I've got to go out into the world and try it. And
oh, yeah.
But I'm used to just the silence doing the jokes now, so I'll be fine. Yeah. I'll be fine.
Abs a bit like that. So are you going to stay around for the caption competition, Kelly?
Yeah, I will do.
Good. Have you seen the pictures?
Yes.
you're just going to wing it, aren't you?
It was a cat. Yeah. I saw a cat in a boat. Yeah.
Cat in a boat.
I don't know, yeah.
There's a joke about that, isn't there, somewhere? Right. Okay. Right. We'll see you later. Give it up. Give it up. Ladies and gentlemen, Kelly Edgar, see you later. Hey. That's brilliant. We're doing really well. Have we caught up on time? It should be 8:49 before we go to Av, because I've got this, like, military precision. So I am going to go to Av, but... I don't know. Shall I go? I'll go to Av. I'll go to Av, and then we'll see what's occurring. That's it. Are you all right, Av? What's occurring?
What's a curry? It's a Asian dish, ain't it?
Asian dish.
Indian, Pakistani, Bangladeshi. Yeah. Is that what you said?
I didn't realise you were multilingual.
Oh, never mind.
I'm just very cunning.
Yeah. Yeah.
I'm glad you laughed, because I thought that was going to fall on stony ground. Yes, you've been out and about doing some reports, haven't you?
I have, haven't I?
You have. You've gone further afield, as it were. Your field has gone further.
Oh, yes. Because the lockdown's kind of opened up a little bit, I've decided to venture out a bit more, have a look what's going on outside.
That is in very the world. Good. Unfortunately, the satellite delay meant I've only got one of your reports, actually. But I could play it now if you want.
Go ahead. Yeah, go ahead.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, Av Singh has been out and about. He's going up and beyond to give us the news. This is...
Where are you? Let's be having you!
Going over now to see Av Singh with some breaking news. Av!
Breaking news, Steve.
That's the wrong one, Av.
Yeah, I'll say.
I've been uploading the wrong things all night.
It's okay.
Do Phil?
I don't know him.
Yeah, all right, Grant. How you getting on, mate? Yeah. You do a Grant. Come on, Grant.
Yeah.
That was like the trumpet player, Satchmo, or is he a Bigfoot? I don't know.
Remember, I could do Get Out of My Pub or Ricky. Oh, that's about it. Really,
oh,
isn't it?
Don't stop it. The people will think they're here. They'll think we've got them in here. Don't do Nigel. Okay. Don't do Nigel.
Do Nigel. From... You know,
if anybody knows Rob Beckett on whatever it is called. He always does Ronnie Corbett, and he can't stop doing... You're like that. You just can't stop doing Nigel Farage. Come on. Give the world your Nigel Farage.
No, 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 no. Should take a bow now. Should take a bow. Should take a bow.
That's
a,
yeah, you yeah. take a Valium, mate. I would.
Brexit.
Hey, Brexit. So, what's been going on in the news then?
I think there's been a little bit out there. There's been a bit at the beginning of the week was about Bill Gates.
Yeah.
Ding, so he's saying his marriage is broken. Apparently, he can't connect to his Wi-Fi. he's got a faulty hard drive. Compatibility issues.
Hold on. Let me ask you again. What else has he got, Av? He's got compatibility issues. Go on. What else?
Microsoft.
And what else has he got?
Slow performance. Unexpected pop-ups. That's what she was saying, anyway.
Anything else?
Anything else? I think there's also been a bit about the Indian variant. What's going on? We found a few more cases. And saying there's it's officially today a concern. But between you and the zero audience, I think...
Oh, no, we got a lot tonight.
You got, sorry.
We're into double digits.
Oh, brilliant. So the only Indians which I'm concerned about are Rishi Sunak and Preeti Patel.
For our international audience, they're a couple of government ministers who we all adore. In fact, I've actually done a little video of our government ministers. Would you like to see it?
Yeah, go ahead.
It took me a long time to make, so I felt, as everything else has like gone to whatever it is, I'll get this right. Here is my little tribute to the ministers that run this country.
Everybody's a bit of a cunt sometimes. Everybody's a bit of a cunt sometimes. We're bastards and we're gits. We're wankers and we're shits. But sometimes that is just one word that absolutely fits. Everybody's a bit of a cunt sometimes. A fact that any Catholic won't deny. I once shagged my girlfriend's sister. My gran's dead. I've never missed her. Ooh, what a cunt. Everybody's a bit of a cunt sometimes.
We've now been banned on YouTube.
Well, I was going to say that it's not right, Steve. Only a bit.
Yeah, I know.
Hell of a lot, like, I think.
It's the music that'll stop me, not the fact that I was lying about those government ministers. Come on, England!
I know. I don't know what to make of today with the voting.
Oh, God, yeah, of course. Yeah.
So that was the news.
We had elections yesterday, local rather than governmental. Apart from one strong Labour seat, wasn't it? Went to the Conservatives.
Yeah, but I think everyone's watching Scotland now, aren't they? Yeah. You know, Scotland's going to break away. Jimmy Cranky's got control. You know.
Oh, God, because she does look like Jimmy Cranky. I'm sure. I'm sure that's not the right thing to say.
I'm going to get some shit from anyone who's Scottish watching. Scottish comedians, perhaps.
They'll leave in a huff. Labour. The Labour, they've lost it, really, haven't they?
Yeah, I mean, come on. Kiev, 5-year warranty. It's not worth it, is it? You know, that's a Kia joke for anyone out there. Kia car. Didn't know what I'm talking about.
I know. He's here for another 5 years. God bless
him. He's got no personality, has he, at all? I was watching him earlier on.
Sorry, I was just checking on something, but I'm back with you now, Av. I'm back in the room. He has got no personality.
He hasn't. He's like, I'm saying to you, he's like, he's someone's cloned. I forgot his name now. What's his name, Steve?
Oh, yeah, if someone's cloned... Tony Blair, you mean?
Tony Blair, before Iraq, right? And they didn't get all the DNA and they missed his personality. That's what you got with Keir Starmer.
Oh, I see. They've cloned Keir Starmer with Tony Blair. Yeah. No, cloned Tony Blair to Keir Starmer.
Yeah. And they left the personality out. Now, I saw him earlier on, he's going to vote, walk into into the building to vote. He's like this. And they realise, oh, cameras are here. I've got to look like morning. He didn't look comfortable at all. I thought, this is the kind of person you want as a leader. You need to bring Jeremy Corbyn back, I think.
That's yes, yes, no, yes. But, I think no, but I think I heard as well that he was saying that, he thinks that he's not gone to the right enough, and that's why Labour aren't doing well, because they still think it's held by the Corbyn type supporters. But I think he's miles away on that. I think that's why they're losing the votes. But anyway, what do I know? I'm a clown in a red hat.
No, you're not a clown.
Found. Go on. If you're going to say talk about me, I'm not stopping you.
No, no, go ahead. Go ahead.
No, no, please talk about me.
I was going to say you're a lovely man, you know, in a red Labour suit.
There you go. There you go.
You should stand for erection, shouldn't you?
I will. If I did, I'd be touching the ceiling. I don't know what that means. Right. I found your outside broadcast. It's here. Let's have a look at Av's first outside broadcast. One of several, or six. Here we go. Breaking news now from Av Singh. Av, what's going on in Wolverhampton?
Breaking news, Steve. I just had a shit.
Thanks for that, Av.
Yeah,
need that was... to shout next time.
Yeah, there was
I couldn't imagine going people on. Walking past.
There was people around. And I got it in the neck. Because right. my son was filming.
I was going to say, you should tell people that, you know, you get your six-year-old son to film you outside in the. Is that gauze? That looked like Canuck Chase to me.
No, it wasn't. It was Kimber.
Kimber or Kimber?
Kimber.
No.
It's a nice place. It's got, well, I should have shown you. It was like, they've got caves where people used to live. Yeah.
Oh, I know. Yeah. In the Wyre Forest? No.
No.
No, Nick, I know nothing.
Is Staffordshire, Kidderminster, kind of? No, yeah, something around there.
We're losing viewers by the minute now. They're all falling asleep, Av. Let's not even go okay. there. Right. Okay.
I'm trying to educate people, Steve.
Good. I'm glad you seem a lot better than you did this morning, mate, and I'm glad about that.
Painkillers. Your personality? Kelly said,
well, no, Kelly said something about the personality. She said, did you just accuse Tony Blair of having a personality, Av?
Before Iraq.
Before Iraq.
Yeah.
Do you know where I keep my wine?
Yeah.
What, in the cellar?
Okay.
Hey, Av, right, we'll see you later for the caption competition. All right, thank you very much. Av Singh! I always want to see Av Singh will travel, but I don't know what that means. So, I know what you're thinking, people. You're thinking, you're sticking to the time, aren't you? You're going to introduce us now to someone who has been in the hen house before, over the pond as well. Over the pond, that's like America, right? Yeah. And it's Jolie RX, if I've said that right.
Yeah, hey, Steve.
Hi, you all right?
Yeah, long time no see, man.
I know, it's good. You're very echoey now. Is that is that the room? Because earlier when we had a little chat, I was thinking, well...
The whole house is echoey. It doesn't have any right angles. Everything's... It's got a lot of harmonic in it. It's hard to explain. Ooh, I'm sorry. It is.
Yeah. You've got... If people don't know this... Yeah. Pardon?
I said, should I get some headphones?
No, I think it'll be fine. It was just... I think... No. I was wondering if I could hear myself then. I always worry about that. No, but your house sitting again in a beautiful, beautiful house in Ohio?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's in the great Midwest.
Have we got your word for that, it's great?
Yeah.
We live in Great Britain.
I don't believe the property, but the house is great.
That's it. But for those, you do like your own comedy. I don't even know what to describe it now, because you're like an industry. The rampantly... Was that right? Yeah. Industry.
Yeah. Yeah, the first time I was on the show was, gosh, what, like back in July or August?
Gotta be.
And yeah, so we have a, you know, I just realized I should have a virtual background like you so I can plug it, but I forgot. Oh. So it's Rampantly. It's a virtual comedy platform. It's at www.rampantly.la. We do like 15 open mics a week. And we pick up virtual shows. So if you're a comedian who has been running a virtual show or you're producing a virtual show and you want to start going back out again to do real live shows, you can consider migrating your show to our platform so that we can help you make it easier to keep running your show. So we have a huge pool of comedians and we do comedy marathons and festivals and lots of fun stuff. It never ends.
Your marathon the other day was like mad. How many shows?
It was crazy. We did 39 shows in 5 days. It was all in one Zoom room, but we were doing like up to 7 shows at the same time. So you could actually walk between them without having to leave the room. It was really fun. Yeah. We partnered with Comedy Therapy, which is out of New Jersey. We partnered with Hot Breath out of Atlanta and lots of independent producers. And now our next big event is the 1st of July. It will be our second annual Comedy. Comedy. It's spelled like Comedy. It's the, and I think that might be how we met last year. It's the 20th.
That's how we saw it.
Yeah, so it'll be 24 straight hours of stand-up comedy live.
And I want to do that. Because I wanted to do it last time. I will. Yeah. We will talk about that.
Well,
I think that's great.
If you want to go on at 3 a.m., you can do it.
But that's 3 a.m. my time or 3 a.m. your time.
3 a.m., right, 3 a.m. Pacific, right, is actually like 11 a.m. UK, so that should be good. You could do that.
Could do that. The only trouble is I don't get up till 12, but I do most of my things in my sleep, so it's fine.
You know, I was looking at those glasses you have on, and I realized, first of all, I didn't know they were two different shapes. It fits you so well. And I was looking at them, and then I realized Facebook actually tried to sell those to me. How awkward would that be right now?
That's it. No, but the ones on Facebook are better because this is less defined square. The ones...
Right, they whittled it down a little bit.
Better square. Yeah. Right. These are cheaper. These are like from some poor Chinese child on eBay.
At least they're being entrepreneurial these days.
Yeah. That's cool. No, right. Kelly's watching, and I saw her ears prick up when you said that you do some open mics, because I bet she'd love to do your show.
Oh, yeah. Oh, please come. I mean, I could just plug the platform the whole time. I don't even know how much time you want me to do jokes for. We've got a show tonight. It's called Red Mic, and it's on in 7 hours. So go to www.rampantly.la, and there's a mic menu. You just scroll down. You click. You can see everyone who's signed up. It's really trippy, so don't get distracted.
Hey, that's cool. Is that something you'd like to do, Kelly? I'm looking. I'm not sure. I don't know. I'll bring her in. Let's see if you can all talk. Look at that. There's Kelly.
Hey.
Do you want to do a ramp? I'm selling the show for you here, but you. It's up to Jolie.
Can I not hear you?
Oh, that's because her mic's off. She's doing very well. Because like, yeah.
Oh.
That's all right. So, I'm a terrible person.
The funny thing is, I was saying I'd need some subtitles because you might not be able to understand my accent. But yeah.
It is.
We're an international platform.
Awesome. Awesome. Cool.
And it's important, you know. We have to expose Americans to other ways of life and other ways of speech. It's good for us.
They've seen Game of Thrones, they'll be fine.
That's right. Yeah. Yeah. They'll understand you. You understand that. Okay.
I think Kelly would go very well in America. And we'll see you in a minute. I'm going to say goodbye to Kelly. Thank you, Kelly. Jolie. Okay, right. RX. Yeah.
That's right.
That is good. As we like to say... Woo! Prescription comedians.
Yeah.
I don't know.
Someone
who
called me Jolie Walgreens. Do you guys have Walgreens over there in the UK?
No, but pharmacies? I assume we have a similar type of.
Yeah.
What do they sell?
It's like a pharmacy.
Oh.
Like maybe or.
We have a Boots the chemist.
Okay, that's my cat's name.
What chemist?
Boots, the chemist.
I found myself hilarious then, and it wasn't funny. Right, okay. Jolie!
Me? I always get scared on this show when you let me in by myself, because this is the one show where you just have to wait for the laughs you think you deserve.
Yeah.
You can't hear anything.
I know, it is tricky. But it's 5 minutes, Jolie.
Oh, just five?
Yeah.
Oh, no, we've been chatting too long. Okay.
That's okay. All right, but Tony's not here yet. So when Tony comes in, I'll do something with this so you can see it.
What?
Like, I'll change the overlay for you, and then you'll know that if you could stop at any point, that'd be lovely. Are you ready?
Okay. To talk? I'll tell everyone about myself. Sure.
You'll be great. You'll be fine. Ladies and gentlemen, back in the hen house, Tony's here.
Okay, my set's over. Nice to meet you all.
Yeah. No, Jolie RX.
Hey, everybody. Hi, good morning. How are you today? My name's Jolie. That's J-O-L-I. Jolie. You might be saying to yourself, oh, that's such a pretty name. I've never heard that before. What does it mean? Well, it actually means pretty French boy. Yeah. So, couldn't tell you. You know, I found this out and I texted my parents, you know, to see like, what were you trying to say? What were you trying to do when you named me that? And I haven't heard from them since. Yeah. Yeah. I was born a pretty French boy, but I grew up into a giraffe. Yeah. I'm a giraffe. I'm, let's see, this is UK. I'm 190 centimeters. That's 75 in American inches, 6'3". Yeah, what's it like to be this tall? Well, for starters, the names that people call me is insults. Jolly Green Giant, Big Bird, Yao Ming. They're all millionaires. So, and my left arm is it's the prototype for the original selfie stick. See that? So, yeah, I said my left arm. My legs and my arms are different lengths. So yeah, my legs are like 3 inches difference. So when it comes to playing sports, I might not always win, but I do run circles around my competition every single time. Yeah. Don't get me wrong. I know how to play sports. Okay. I do. I got to demystify that. I'm a woman, but I know how to play sports. Okay. And I would be great at them if it weren't for this like quizzical look on my spine. Yeah, you know, so you see, if you x-ray me, my skeleton is actually shaped like a question mark. Yeah, I hide it well. When I first found out, you know, looking at the x-ray, I said, Doc, what is wrong with me? He said, yes. So I'm not great at sports, but I still like them. You guys like sports? We love them in America. We don't love your sports, British people, but we love sports. I don't love sports because I'm good at them, but I do love sports because they babysit my boyfriend. Yeah, I just got to be sure to lay him on his back in front of the TV, you know, so he doesn't spit up and roll over. Yeah, that's right. I found myself a boyfriend during quarantine. Round of applause for me. Thank you very much. How? Your guess is as good as mine. We met in a Zoom comedy show. During COVID, you know, thank God. It's like, not often can you meet a guy and spend your whole first, second, and third dates like cropped off at the waist. It's kind of fun for me, you know. It's like back in before times. I always used to get cropped out of group photos, but it was at the neck, you know. Especially in high school, I show up at my class reunion, like, remember me? Paging through the yearbook. Sorry, you gotta show us your tits. We got nothing else to go by. The face doesn't ring a bell. You know? As a freakishly tall woman, going out to parties was something that I've been glad to kind of take a break from this year. You know, you would too, if your best party trick was accidentally startling the host and hitting your head on the ceiling fan, in that order. I can also hail a cab from down the block and around the corner. You know, have I mentioned how long my arms are? Yeah. It's the kind of skill that you only learn that you have when you're like quickly exiting a party with a bleeding forehead. People! Okay. I'm so tall. Before COVID, when I was single, strangers all across town, I'm seeing the chat, would pick me up. They'd pick me out in public, in the grocery store, the bank, the park, people I'd never met. They'd come up to me they'd ask, I'd say, you're so unbelievably tall. Do you date short guys? Actually, wait. Short guys would ask. Yeah. And, you know, it was like sooner or later, like it got to the point, like I had to tell them, gentlemen, you know, as a tall, I'm a tall with a capital T. Okay. And a dwindling fertility window. Okay. So after 15 years of unsuccessful dating, yes. Are you taller than a fifth grader? Okay. Let's get coffee. Right. Actually, on second thought, you can also sign my permission slip, give me your juice box. And last but not least, and this is real, this is an adult thing. When we go out for coffee, you got to ask the barista to make you a tall. Okay. Can you do that for me? Yeah. How tall is a fifth grader, by the way, Steve? Do you know? How tall? None of us, no childless, unincarcerated adult should ever wonder the answer to that question. Yeah. The fifth grade, though, do you remember those days? I do. Yeah, I remember those days. There were no female role models for me. None. No female role models. What were there? There was Barbie doll and there was like all the basketball stars. Okay, we already talked about basketball. My basketball team in high school, they wiped the floor. They mopped the floor with me. You got to say mopped, not wiped, because the thing was, they thought I was a broom handle. That's where that phrase comes from. And you don't realize that's where it comes from unless you're the one they're doing it to, because of how scrawny you are with your stringy hair. Yeah, being held upside down by your ankles. Anyway, Steve, I'm trying to be fast. How much time do I have? Should I say the last thing? Here's the last, I'll end on this, okay? Last thought, okay? So like I said, the comparison that people make between me and tall people, it's not that fun, okay? But I did find something I could hold on to. My role model as a child, still my role model today, the Statue of Liberty, the tallest woman in America. And you know, she's more than just that. Like, on top of being the tallest woman in America, you know, and at night, you know, she stands as a symbol of freedom and liberty from tyranny out there in the Atlantic Ocean, welcoming people into New York City. But on the side, if you've never been, you have to go. She lets immigrants and tourists pay her $5 so they can slip up under her dress and climb up her spine and peer out her eyeballs, just like me. Steve, are you there? Are you still there? I feel like I've been talking for a long time. Hello? Hello?
I am here, but I was doing something, and I wanted to do it secretly, but so that's all right. Yeah, good. I like that. That was lovely. I feel that you probably were cropped off of your school photos in your yearbook, and I felt for that. I felt. Hey, do you want to do the caption competition?
What do we do?
Well, I will show you some pictures and you've got to say something funny. I say you've got to.
I saw you posted them, but I actually didn't look at them.
Well, I don't think Kelly did either. And probably Tony didn't either. And but at least I'm here and have looked at them. I'm just going to get them up on my screen for everyone. So let's say hello to Kelly, Av, and Tony. Tony's here. Hello, Tony. Say hello to everybody.
Hello. Hello, everybody. Hi.
Hey.
Brilliant. That's good. Right. Av, would you like to talk about the first caption competition while I sort this out?
Which one is it?
I have no idea. Which one do you want it to be? I can make it. Okay. Whichever one you want to talk about, it'll be that one.
Okay. Put it up then. Let's have a look at it.
No, I've got to get... is it this one? I think I have to do a bit of manoeuvring around to get everyone over on that side, and then I'm going to go with that one.
Hey.
So if anyone has got anything funny to say about that picture, now would be the time.
I've got a man regrets buying his blow up doll from Wish.
Oh. I was going to say, is he thinking this valve's a bit tight?
Ooh.
This is not what we meant when we said we were going to have a ball on the beach.
Hey.
Steve, I just realised he looks a bit like you.
That's just, that's unfair. That's ageist, that is. That's terrible. I had one similar to Kelly's, really, which was Royal Institute of the Blind introduce inflatable sex doll, the economy model.
Medical experts warn about multicoloured swollen testicle
syndrome. What happens when you get COVID? The symptom, isn't it?
Beach balls.
Well, the size of them.
Look, no hands. Hey, shall we move on? Because it's just going to get rude now, isn't it? It's just going to be what a lot of cock and bull. Right. This one. This is a difficult one. This is where Tony will have to do this one.
I got one. I got.
Oh, good.
Look, boss, you put me in a boat with the owl. You knew it was going to happen.
I have a similar. We're on the same lines, but cat sends owl pussy pic.
Oh.
I'm going to cover my head.
What I've got is puss in boats. It doesn't work.
Nice.
No, it'll do, though. It'll
do.
Yeah,
that's fucking by the look of it, isn't it?
Hmm?
There's a lot going on in that picture, isn't there?
It is, really. I've got penguins caught catnapping.
I didn't see the penguins as well.
Yeah. It was in his pocket. He'd just gotten from Morrison's. Cat scan.
I think that cat's actually trying to take a picture of the guy from the previous photo, isn't he, on the beach?
We should put that in there. Hey, that's good. Right, okay. This is Av sent me this one. I like this one a lot. That's
Hands
Boris
up
Johnson.
If you're a cunt.
Hi, Hitler.
That reminds me of an old joke that we used to do at school when it was like, stand up the boy with the horn, and the whole class stood up.
This is Boris waves to his children from the required legal distance of 100 yards.
That's good. I put Boris waves fond farewell to the Labour Party. Funny. Too soon?
Too soon.
I've always been ahead of my time.
I was going to say, is he hailing down Keir Starmer? Is he driving a taxi now?
Rare photo appears online of Prime Minister owning up.
Nice. It was me. I killed them all.
God bless him. Right, anybody, you can have one more if you want. Nobody? Right.
I got one. Boris is a twat anyway, whatever picture you see him in.
If you look at the news, not many people would... We've got a viewer. Boris Johnson dresses as his hero Donald Trump for the Queen's Halloween ball. There's a lot going on there. Queen's Halloween ball. We know Richard, don't we, Jolie? I would imagine.
We know.
Cool. Yeah, I thought so. Good. Right. That's good. I'm going to finish off mine because mine is, I wrote this down earlier, and Prime Minister does impression of Sooty with no clothes. Hang on. Oh. Right, let me get rid of this. Stop scaring the screen, Steve. Come on. No, I don't know how to do it. Why aren't you? Oh, I know, because he's still there, Boris, you twat. Hey! Thank you all very much. Tony's here in the building. We're going to have a little chat with Tony, and Tony's going to do his stuff. As you can see, he's live at the Apollo. Whoa. So thank you very much, Jolie, Av, and Kelly, and here's Tony.
Hello, Steve.
Are you all right?
Yeah, I'm all right. Yeah, look at this. You're lucky to get me. Look, I was filming today at the BBC. Look, I'm doing my my spot live at the Apollo there. Sorry.
Have you just done what I've? Have you? Did you just change it? Oh. Because I while I saw that, I did one myself to say that I was there as well.
You were at the B&M home store.
But yeah, did so you will be on live at the Apollo Tone, don't you worry about that.
Possibly. I might just change my house's name to Apollo so I can claim that I live at the Apollo.
Well, yeah. Do me a favour tonight.
Do your garden joke.
I like that.
Do my garden.
If I say any more, it might. But don't do it straight away. Now you'll have to put it in sort of towards the end, really.
Look at that. I realise, point in the right direction. Without the green screen up, it kind of look. That looks a bit weird, doesn't it? On the on the photo there.
Oh yeah, no, mine does that because I got a white wall and it goes sort of do that.
I might turn it off. Yeah, sorry to break the illusion of people there. It was a joke. I wasn't alive at the Apollo at all. It was just a bit of a game.
Yeah, but you will be. You will be.
I will be. Steve. If I keep doing gigs... shows for you, someone out there, the booker at live at the Apollo will be watching. They'll get me on.
That's it. You never know who they share these people with. They share them to a lot of the West Midlands police. I know that for sure. So don't you worry about that. Are gigs opening up for you now? Are you getting books?
Yeah, starting to get booked now. So gigs are coming back. So yeah, I've got a few in the next couple of weeks. What's D-Day? It's the 17th of March, isn't it? I think, is it 17th of March, D-Day?
I'm so glad you asked that because I'm always prepared
from
the date.
From the 8th of March, 29th of March, then the 12th of April, the 6th of May, and the 17th of May. We'll begin no earlier than the 21st of June.
Yeah.
Okay, well that was clear, wasn't it?
21st of June, I think, is meant to be D-Day. Yeah.
Oh, is it?
So
what's happening? Isn't stuff starting to open in May though, isn't it? I don't know. I've got some gigs booked in anyway.
Oh yeah, no, the 17th of May is the next opening thing, but apparently we can all go to the cinema and sit next to people and cough on the 21st of June. We can do everything then.
Oh, brilliant. I look forward to it.
That's the full open, as somebody might say in a weird way, but I'm not going to. So have you got any gigs near me?
Well, I forget where you're based, Steve. Where are you?
Well, let's say Birmingham. I can go anywhere within a 20-mile radius of Birmingham easily.
20-mile radius of Birmingham.
Maybe.
I'll be honest with you, I've got such an appalling memory, I can't remember where my gigs are booked for, but they're probably not too far from Birmingham. I tend to mostly be gigging sort of around the Midlands. Obviously, I'm East Midlands, so...
Of course.
Tend to do.
Excellent. How nice will it be when you come and do my real live Henn Night show at the Palace Theatre?
It'd be lovely. I don't know if I'll be... How am I going to cope when there's actual people, though? It's going to be weird.
It's going to be... It is. But I think, really, it'd be like falling off a bike. It'll fucking hurt.
It'll be funny for people watching in a similar way.
Yeah. No, but I think you're just, you know, after you... I think as soon as you get your first laugh, surely it'll just be... And relax. I would hope.
So once I'm about an hour in.
Excellent. All right, look, I could talk all night to anybody. Not just anybody, but especially to you, Tony. Right, so here we go. We're going to let you do your stuff. It's Tony Cowards with my request that he won't forget. So
I'll do that first before I forget it. How long do you want me to do, by the way?
What's the time now? Well, five to six.
5 to 6 minutes?
Yeah.
All right.
But yeah. Because I'm trying to keep this down, but I've chatted far too long. We started off with... All right. Tony!
Hey! Thank you very much. Thank you, Steve. Yeah, welcome, everyone. So just for Steve, then, first of all, he requested it. So I've been to the garden centre today to spend a couple of hours standing in the middle of my garden. So yes, has been a weird day. I put the recycling out today as well. Yeah, apparently you're not supposed to set fire to it. And I bumped into my neighbour today, and he told me that his wife had been killed by Spanish terrorists. I said, "Etta?" He said, "No, they blew her up." So, also, it's been a weird day. All sorts of things have been happening to me. I spilt glue on my autobiography today. Well, that's my story, and I'm sticking to it. So, a little bit about me. I used to be a child psychologist until I turned 18. Then I became an adult psychologist. That's how that works. And I, as a kid, I was addicted to helter skelters. Yeah, my parents were worried that I was spiraling out of control. So what else do you need to know about me? I always go the extra mile, ladies and gentlemen, which is why my Uber rating is shit. And my ambition, one of my ambitions, ladies and gentlemen, is to open the world's greatest pub for short people. Although I do fear I may have set the bar too high. So I'm genuinely upset, ladies and gentlemen, genuinely upset about the printing error in my new book. There are no words. People say, don't they? People say that a child's brain is like a sponge, but for spillages, I still prefer a mop. My plan, ladies and gentlemen, my plan to build a multi-story car park has just one floor. My friend, this has happened to me the other day. It's weird. My friend, honestly, this definitely happened. My friend got refused entry to a fancy dress party for going as a kitchen wash basin. Just let that sink in. Here's a bit of advice. If you're ever buying Vladimir Putin a drink, don't ask him what's him. A bit of sad news. Well, I don't know if you heard this, but today the inventor of the JCB died. Yeah, and his family have said that he'll leave a massive hole. Spanking Dwayne Johnson, ladies and gentlemen. Spanking Dwayne Johnson. That was when I really knew I'd hit rock bottom. So I did. I went over to Hollywood, actually. That's where I met Dwayne Johnson. That's where I ended up spanking. I was over in Hollywood. I went for a job, and they said to me, "So, Mr. Cowards, could you tell us why you'd like to be a film editor?" I said, well, to cut a long story short, and they gave me the job. So that was nice. Yeah, the hardest job I ever had in Hollywood, though, the hardest job I ever had was being the publicist for the film Fight Club, because the first rule was very prohibitive. I'm not always a fan of Hollywood, though. I hate the way Hollywood has to change everything. For instance, the film Twister is nothing like the game. So my granddad, I spoke to my granddad today. My granddad has just exchanged his German sausage for a common seabird. Yeah, unfortunately, he's taken a turn for the worst. I've made it my new ambition as well is to get involved in the snow globe industry because I just want to shake things up a little. I've had loads of different jobs. There were loads of different jobs, AJ, before I became a comedian. For instance, I actually trained to be a locksmith. Yeah, I studied at Yale. And I have to say that opened a lot of doors for me. I also used to be the DJ at Stonehenge, although I no longer mix in those circles. I was also, for a little while, I was a manager at the Energy Efficiency Council. I got sacked for telling my staff that my door was always open. And I was also, for a little while, I was the manager of a struggling boat shop. Had a genius idea of lowering the ceilings. And of course, immediately sales went through the roof. So ever since my best friend started working at the grease factory, he's been incredibly hard to get hold of. A bit of advice for you, running with Scrabble tiles is all fun and games until someone loses an eye. And for a bit of advice for any budding criminals out there, right? If you're going to commit a crime, here's the thing. If you're going to commit a crime, do it dressed as a handbag, because that way you can only be charged with being an accessory. So I don't know if anyone out there can help, anyone wants a job, because I need someone to look after all my herbs and spices, but no time wasters. I wish I had a pound, ladies and gentlemen. I wish I had a pound for every time I've found a stray dog. There's a bit of a thing. I've been learning all different facts like at the moment because I love my pub quizzes and stuff. And I don't know if you know this. If we've got any people from Yorkshire here, they might know this, but anyone else? Before the big scandal, Harrogate was just known as Harrow. Also found out about blood groups. Don't know if you know this. The most common blood group in Taiwan is type A. Most common blood group amongst depressed people, B negative. And the most common blood group amongst dyslexics, type O. So when When we started doing calzone, my pizza restaurant folded. Amnesiacs. Just who the hell do they think they are? So I'm trying to get into mind reading. The people out there trying to get into mind reading. Any thoughts? Sorry, I've got some, I'm not reading these off here, honestly. If someone offered me £1 million to become a cannibal, I'd bite the hand off. And a bit of a request, actually, for anyone there. If anyone has a photo of me taken from far away, that'd be great. I know it's a long shot. A lot of men, I find this bizarre, a lot of men find Catwoman sexy, don't they? A lot of men find Catwoman sexy, but I just think that's because they've never seen her in next door's garden burying her own shit. I do have a lot of questions. I don't know if anyone else is like this. My brain is very active. I have a lot of questions that keep me awake at night. Questions like, can you get acupuncture to cure pins and needles? Is Cajun chicken the opposite of free range chicken? And the biggest question that keeps me awake at night is what is the technical term for the underneath of an elephant? Because I love elephants, but I don't know what to call the underneath of an elephant, right? Some people say it's his stomach. Some people say it's chest. I've heard people say it's flanks, underbelly. I had someone brilliantly suggest that it was the bellifant. It should be called the bellifant, the underneath of an elephant, the bellifant, which I think is brilliant. I think we should adopt that term because it's a difficult, isn't it? It's difficult to know what to call the underneath of an elephant. It's a huge grey area. Yes, that was a long build-up for that punchline. So what else can I tell you about myself? I like to take pictures of Irish builders' bums, yeah, just for the crack. This is a really weird one. I had to sort out a fight the other day. Two of my friends were arguing about the best way to make a toasted sandwich, and I had to play Breville's advocate. Never get into an argument, ladies and gentlemen. I'm giving you lots of advice here. There's more advice for you. Never get into an argument on the moving stairs in a department store because that can escalate very quickly. So, ladies and gentlemen, I might leave you on this last thing because I want to keep it quite short for Steve here. I hope you've enjoyed some of my jokes here. My name's Tony Cowards, by the way. If you do Twitter and Facebook, social media and all that sort of thing, look up Tony Cowards at Tony Cowards. On there, and that'd be brilliant. You can see me because I am starting to do gigs again, and perhaps you can see me live somewhere around the UK. That'd be fantastic. So I'll leave one last thing, ladies and gentlemen. I'll tell you what, because I'm not an annoyed person most time, but I'll tell you what really gets my back up: portable hard drives. So there you go. So I'm going to hand you back to Steve. You've had a brilliant show. I think I've been Tony Cowards. I've really enjoyed this. Have a fantastic weekend. Thank you very much, Lady Joe, and I'll hand you back to your wonderful host, Steve. Thank you. I've been Tony Cowards.
He has been Tony Cowards. Excellent. I've found been two Tony dates Cowards, for you.
I will remain Tony Cowards.
That's it. I'm Tony Cowards. I found two dates. Anyway, Derby and Nottingham.
Oh.
But they're very really, Midlands,
they're a bit
though.
Far from you, aren't they? But I'm sure I'll be in the West Midlands soon.
That's it. No, I'll come and see you if I can. But I don't know if I'll be able to like shake your hand or anything. I'll have to like just.
I think we have to do the. Don't we have to do the elbow bump at the moment?
I can't. Can we do that? I was going to say I met my.
If I can work out which way's which, we could do it on the screen, can we?
No, do you think? I don't. It's very difficult.
There we go. Oh, look at that. There we go.
Hey, we'll have to do it. One, two, move it out and then move it in. One, two, trip, tip. What?
We're like the Chuckle Brothers. To me, to you.
No, but we're not as... No, let's not go down that path.
Yeah, don't, Tony. As I said that, don't start going down that road.
No. Is Av still here? Because I'm going to say goodbye to everybody. I don't know. If Av's here, we'll say... Bring Jolie in. Jolie RX. In a beautiful mansion.
That is a beautiful house, yeah.
Oh, you should. When we had a little camera check earlier, she was in the downstairs. That was beautiful. I don't think Av's here, but look, we could bring him in. Hi, Av. You all right? Yeah, no, I think that as well, mate. Yeah, all right. So it's only,
it's thanks, only, Av.
Only three of us left. So we'll all say goodbye and thank everybody for watching. Yeah, keep comedy live and on stream for a little longer and see what happens. But well, thank you both.
Thank you. I was just going to say, hopefully these sort of gigs will carry on, even with the live gigs coming back.
Yeah, no, I think so. I'm going to try as well when I do the live show at the theatre to bring in the TV screen and get people from around the world in to do a 5-minute Zoom gig so that at least they'll get a reaction.
So funny. So funny.
Well, I think we're losing the connection with you, Jolie, because it's we can't. It's a ventriloquist thing.
Yeah.
I can hear me coming back there. All right. Well, say goodbye to everybody. Thank you so much. Watch the Hen House next week. We've got some people on it. And I'll show you who now, because I'm so good unless I've written them down. Bye!
Fuck you. Goodbye. You hurt me for the last time. It's time for me to move on. So fuck you and goodbye. I gave you love and I hate it. Yeah, all of the time that I wasted. Fuck you, goodbye. You hurt me for the last time.